All right, before the Switch, before the Game Boy, there was this. Remember this, Ben?
I don't.
Keep watching. Back in the 80s, this, guys, was cutting-edge mobile gaming. Nintendo's Game and Watch only had one game and a clock. It was all on a black and white screen. Well, to celebrate its 35th anniversary.
Oh,
almost as old as Prince
Henry. No way!
I knew you'd love it. Nintendo bringing it back with some new extras. The screen has color this time, and you can play a few, ooh, Ben, Super Mario games on the device. Look how happy he is. Ben. Ben, you just twitted. You twittered.
Oh, God, I need that. Oh.
I knew you would be happy, but this has surpassed my wildest expectations.
I love that game.
You do?
Super Mario Brothers was my jam.
Yes.
I would play that while other people are out meeting girls. I played Super Mario Brothers over and over and over and over and over again.
I'm surprised you're so happy at its return, given the context of what you just gave us.
No, I got the girl now. I got the girl now and go back to the games.
And not only do you have the girl, then you've got the game in color.
Oh, I want that so much.
Oh. I'm so happy for you right now.
Oh, okay.
I knew you'd be happy. When your excitement level was low, I was a little disappointed. I didn't
know what I was looking at, but yeah. Now I can bring Super Mario Brothers with me wherever I go.
Now, you know, instead of ignoring me on your phone at the desk, you can just ignore me while you're playing Super Mario Brothers.
Yeah, but I like to play it with the song. I got to be quiet.
In the studio.
So I don't like playing it silently.
I'm just kidding. Ben doesn't ignore me. Can you make that sound again that you did when you found out it was coming back?
No, it was a spontaneous utterance.
I don't know what it was. I don't know. I'm just going to call a 10-year-old girl. She might be able to do it.
It was like a zebra sound. It really was. Like if a zebra could be a human.
It was. Kelsey, you're exactly right.
100% it was.
What is it when animals and humans do things that are alike?
Anthropomorphizing.
No, that's not.
Well,
that's
it is the word.
You know what my role used to be with Super Mario Brothers? This is like classic big brother move. My brother, who's 7 years older than me, would have me sit beside him and write notes about like the key sequence for the different like up, sideways, up, back, to get into the secret levels. And that was my job. And I had to sit there.
You were like a decoder.
Sorry, I gotta stop here. Anthropomorphism is the attribution of human traits, emotions, or intentions to non-human entities.
I believe you did it the other way around.
But I'm just saying.
You asked me what I was said earlier.
I know.
But when you say the word, it just doesn't sound real.
It's
like when I say meteorological and you all go blink, blink. It's the same thing.
Thanks for watching. If you like this, be sure to subscribe here.
And you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.